Ginger journeyed to Washington, D.C., where there is an amazing little restaurant which has been named the number two best new restaurant in the U.S. by Bon Appetit magazine. Wow, that's a big deal, right? Ginger met up with the chef of Bad Saints, who cooked up, well, what might well be food for the gods. Oh my gosh, pray tell. Ginger, what's in that pinakbet?
Hey guys, I'm in Washington, D.C., standing outside Bad Saint, voted the number two best new restaurant in the United States. I also had the pleasure of hanging out with Bad Saint's head chef, Tom Cunanan, to better understand what drives him to bring Filipino food to the next level. The nation's capital, the heartbeat of America's democracy, and often fiery political discourse. But in recent years, D.C. has been stirring things up as a big player in America's culinary scene. Right in the mix of it all, Filipino food.
Everything about this cuisine, for me, it's really powerful. I feel driven, like every day cooking this food. Like the Filipinos that walk in here, it's like I want to blow their expectation away. It means a lot to me. This is all I got. I'm Tom Cunanan, head chef of Bad Saint, and I cook Filipino food. This is the DuPont Farmers Market that happens here every Sunday in D.C. If you want to get the best produce, you come here. We're going to pick up a few vegetables to make a vegan pinakbet today. So we'll take these and we'll grab some tomatoes. Just look at these vegetables, like they're beautiful. I see some okra.
This is gonna be enough?
I think so, I think that's more than enough.
Yeah.
So pinakbet, I think it's like this is like super savory. And I look at these garlic capes. They're actually like one of my favorite things to use because they're so garlicky and they have a really good texture to them.
Vegan pinakbit, two words you don't usually hear side by side. But this is where Tom's culinary creativity thrives. And it is what has gotten him and Bad Saint national fanfare. The New York Times has called Bad Saint's food richly compelling, extraordinary, and has summed it up as Filipino food that is worth the wait. The Washington Post raves about Bad Saint. And then there's Bon Appetit's ranking as second best new restaurant in the U.S. in 2016, a first for any Filipino restaurant.
What made me decide to cook Filipino food was when my mom was diagnosed with cancer and she wanted to pass along her recipes to me. At the time, I was a little lost myself. Part of it was like my soul didn't belong in that cuisine until my mom, she inspired me to cook Filipino food.
Tom's mom didn't witness Bad Saint open to the public, nor did she live to experience the praises for her son.
I dream about her. She told me she loved me. And I told her I loved her back and I miss her. And it makes me happy. You know, like just like, just know that like her presence is with me like all day long here at Bad Saint. White onion, chives. I'm gonna add this olive bagong. Basically Spanish olives with ginger, onions, scallions. It's disgusting, I'm kidding.
Tom's vegan pinakbet is ready to be served in a traditional palayok, a detail not only inspired by his mother's own cooking, but a reminder of the culture and tradition behind his food.
So the name Bad Saint comes from this old fishing town in Louisiana. It's called Saint Malo, and it's the first U.S. Filipino settlement.
For Tom, a James Beard finalist for Best Chef in 2017, the fire still burns to bring Filipino food, culture, and tradition to new heights from his small yet impactful kitchen in Columbia Heights.
Now, for them to wait in line for 2 hours, you know, it means that they want to try something totally different from what they're familiar with. And for me, that's always been a goal at Bad Saint.